Today is May 1st, the big brew day, and we've already done one brew today, but now we're doing a big 5-gallon batch with Northern Brewer Supply. And this is the Blue Loon Wee Ale, which is a clone of the Blue Loon Wee Ale that you know and love in the store. First thing we have here is some corn sugar. That's for bottling. We'll just set that up to the side. Here's our instructions on how to brew it. And it looks like we have some wheat malt syrup and some gold malt syrup. 3.15 pounds each. And we've got a pound of wheat dry malt extract. What do we got there?
Coriander.
Some coriander seeds.
Hallertau.
German, so if anybody knows how to pronounce them, please don't be afraid to correct me.
And some orange peel.
Yeah.
And it's all packed nice in the box.
That's everything that comes with your kit. They give you the option to choose your yeast, and we went with Omega Yeast OYL 004 West Coast Ale. I don't have the package because I actually already went ahead and put it into here, my yeast starter. So, going in there. That again is Omega OYL 004 West Coast Ale. That's the yeast we're using. Okay, so this recipe has no steeping in it, so we skip that step and we just go straight to boiling. So once this reaches boil, we're gonna add these two things of malt extract, wheat malt extract and gold malt extract. And then at that point we'll start the 60 minute boil. Alright, our water has reached boil point. So it's time to add the dry malt extract and the two things of liquid malt extract. Really want to make sure you get as much of that liquid out of there as you can.
So I let them sit upside down for that little bit of time that you watch me put the tap back on, and we got like probably 4 ounces more out of each of them, I would say.
That's where your malt sugar is, that's where your flavor is, and that's where your original gravity is going to come from. That's where your alcohol is going to come from. I just gotta stir this till it's dissolved, and then we gotta bring it back up to a boil. Once it reaches a boil again, we're gonna add our Hallertau hops. I believe that's how they're pronounced. Not sure on that. Feel free to correct me. As soon as it hits a boil, we're gonna start our timer for 60 minutes. Add the Hallertau hops, and then we're gonna let it boil for 55 minutes. We'll add our coriander seeds and then our orange peel with 5 minutes left. We'll let it boil for 5 minutes more and then it'll be done. It'll be time to cool it down, put it in our fermenter, and add the yeast. I did forget to mention that after you add all of this and you try to bring it back up to a boil, while it's heating up, it may try to boil over on you, bubble off, overflow. Just keep an eye on it. If it's looking like it's going to boil over, pull it off of the burner, stir it a little bit, let it calm down, put it back on the burner, warm it up real slow, let it reach a boil. Like I said, keep an eye on it, stir it occasionally. That'll help it not boil over on you and make a huge mess. So, it's something to be aware of. Reached the end of our boil, so now it's time to cool it down. So we're gonna use this. It's the Cold Crank Mini Immersion Chiller from Northern Brewer. Picked up, it was like less than $60, I wanna say. And it works really, really well for 5 gallon batches, so use that.
You essentially just hook it up to the water source and then it runs cold water all the way through these, I believe they're copper. They look copper, these copper.
Right? It's either copper or brass, same.
Some sort of metal.
Basically the same.
And it cools it down quicker.
I believe it's copper. I believe it is copper. And this has been soaking in our star sand solution. But real quick, I want to hit it with, this is star sand in just a spray bottle. I'm just going to hit it real quick. And then you can go ahead and set it right in there. And then we have a little adapter for our sink that it fits onto. It was like $12 off of Amazon, or you can probably get one at Lowe's or Home Depot. It's just it's a adapter for your sink. You take your regular sink filter off, and you put this adapter on, and it's for a regular garden hose. I believe it's a 3/4 inch pipe. I'm not 100% sure on that, but it's a regular garden hose attachment. And then you just run really.
Just remove your screen part of your sink off.
And then, so you attach the one end to your sink. Or if you can't do that, you can also use your washer dryer attachment if you want to do that. And then the other end doesn't have anything on it. You just put that in the drain in your sink. And then you go ahead and you just crank the cold water on. And you let that cold water run through there. We just shoved it right down inside of our garbage disposal, so it's not a big deal.
And it drops the temperature down about 2 degrees every minute.
Wicked, wicked fast. If you want, I'll find my thermometer right here. And I'll get you an actual close-up video here of how quickly it does drop the temperature down.
But it's about 2 degrees every minute.
It's wicked, wicked fast. Alright, yeah, we'll give us a second here to get set up and we'll give you an actual real-time video of how quick this does chill it.
So we have it going right now inside. Here's our thermometer.
Yeah, you see how quick that's going? That was even quicker than you said. That was like 4 degrees in about 30 seconds.
This is a real-time video. We're not speeding it up or anything. I'm like a terrible cameraman. I'm very shaky.
And you can also, like, with this one, instead of just setting it in there, you can actually move it around inside your pot like I'm doing here. I accidentally hit the thermometer there, but... So you can actually kind of stir it up a little bit while you're cooling it down, and it just drops. Or you can just leave it right there.
Let me focus on what he's doing.
And it just drops so fast.
See, it's just the copper coils in there.
You just stick it in there, and that cold water, you can feel it. You can literally feel it, the cold, how cold it is. And it's just carrying all that heat right out of here.
It's just connected to our sink. And then we just have, this is just the water, the cold water that's flowing through those copper coils getting discarded back down into here, because obviously it's not going into here.
Can you feel in the return line, can you feel it? Is it warm?
Yeah, it's very warm.
Yeah, that's all the heat from this boiling water that we just got done boiling being carried out of here quickly. Look at this. It's already down to almost 150.
And it was over 180 when we started.
Yeah, it was literally boiling. This water was literally boiling 10 minutes ago.
And we're at 1 minute and 40 seconds in, and it's already dropped 20 degrees.
That's 3 gallons of water. Wow.
So I would say this attachment is definitely worth it because you would... I mean, I personally wouldn't want this hooked up to my washing machine, but when he suggested that, I was kind of not impressed, but this is what he went with, thank God.
Yeah, so I think it was like $55 or $60 for the water chiller, and then $12 for the attachment, so you're out $65, $70. Or you can upgrade and get another one. The stainless steel one, I believe, was $60, and the bigger one of the copper, which again was just a big coil which would fit right inside of your pot, which you couldn't stir up like this one. That one, I believe, was $70 or $75. This is, again, from Northern Brewer's website. You can shop around and maybe get one cheaper.
And they have a couple different styles, too. Isn't just this style. There's a different, another style that's, like, a little larger as well.
Right? There's different styles of chillers. You could always go with, like, a plate chiller, which is... I don't know a lot about plate chillers, so I won't get into that. But there's all different kinds of ways to chill your beer. There's bigger... immersion chillers like this, but again, I went with this one because I'm only chilling like 3 gallons of liquid at a time, and as you can see, it works out pretty well for me.
The only thing I've ever seen him this excited about was his tilt hydrometer, so.
And we'll show you that coming up here, probably tomorrow when I actually pitch the yeast, but.
What do you want the temperature to be at when you pitch the yeast?
Ideally, you want to chill this down until you reach your pitching temperature for your yeast. I know with most ales and whatever, it's room temperature 72. Your lagers are going to be colder. Your saisons, or however they're pronounced, are going to be higher temperature. I believe like 90 degrees or something like that. For this one, we're aiming for like 72 degrees. That's where I usually aim for.
Yeah, we're almost there. We were at a little over 180, and we're at 130 right now. Alright, we'll see ya later.
Alright, so we're ready to transfer our beer from our kettle into our fermenter, which is down here on the floor. You can't really see it. This is my auto siphon that I'm going to use instead of dumping it all in there. You just do a little couple of good pumps like that. She should just take off by herself. And she's gone. Maybe I can show you that. As you can see, my beer's going in there. Got my tilt hydrometer floating around in there. Or if you are going to dump it in there, just make sure you don't get the sediment at the bottom of the kettle there. Okay, simple as that with the auto siphon. Okay guys, here we are. Today is Monday. I brewed this beer on, it was Saturday, late Saturday night going into Sunday morning, into the early hours, so... This has been sitting around for about a day and a half. Just the wort here, without any yeast in it. It should be fine. It's been sitting in. This is fully sanitized. Got the airlock and lid on it. Should be perfectly fine. It's only been a day. So, I had to wait for my yeast starter to get done. That I made with some proper yeast starter from Beer & Wine Hobby. Great people to... do some business with if you're into brewing your own beer. So we're just going to decant all the spent wort off, and we just want that yeast cake on the bottom. We're just going to leave just a little bit in there to swirl it up and get it all mixed up good. Dump it in there. Spoon here. I already sanitized it, but I'm just gonna hit it real quick. Just for good measure. Gotta stir the crap out of this. Just aerate the crap out of this. Slosh it around, get all the bubbles in there. confident you got a good amount of oxygen in your wort, go ahead and get your yeast. In they go. Do your stuff, fellas. Spray the bottom of this lid real quick just to make sure it's sanitized. Pop that back on. Like I said, the airlock is already on there. It's already got sanitized water in it. So that's it for this beer, at least for the brewing. Time for it to ferment, and trying to think. I don't believe there are any additives to this while it's fermenting, so just wait till she's done. Wait till my till hydrometer tells me that it's done, and then we'll check it with hopefully my refractometer will be here by then, and I can check it with that. So, starting OG of, I think it was 1055 or 1057, somewhere in there. Excited about this one. Can't wait. See you later. Thank you.